and I will, our project was basically on unmanned aerial system sensors. And the sensors that we tested were infrared imagery, so IR, multispectral, and RGB. The multispectral sensor that we used was a Mika Sense Red M, which costs like $4,900. And it's good for coral flow maps that can measure plant health. The IR sensor was a FLIR Dual Pro R, which costs $7,600. And the RGB camera that we used two of them, was the Panasonic Glumix GH4, which is $1,000, and the GoPro Hero 3 Plus, which is $200. And we hypothesized that the RGB camera on the Phantom 4 was the most ideal for that sort of thing.
Alright, so our methods was that we were going to fly the lake. It's up here on the right-hand side over at Camp Park to see if the space would be usable for an event and which sensor would give us the most usable data. So we took out the Phantom Pro 4. Phantom Pro 4, and we flew the lake. We were able to get all these really cool pictures. Look at the area around it and see if the soil was usable, if the space was big enough to bring cars in. We wanted to take the multi-spec up, but unfortunately, due to technical issues, like the Wi-Fi range not being long enough, we decided to just fly the airstrip, because that was gonna be a little safer for our sensors. And then, so we flew a grid pattern, which is what resulted in these maps. And that was flown on the 3DR Solo. We then took a GoPro, flew the same grid pattern over Condor Field, and then we had Aerial Alchemy come in, fly their IR sensor over Condor Field and the little creek that runs through Camp Park.
Okay, so you have a total of two pictures on the right side. Those two are taken by the GoPros. And so you had the drone was at 50 meters and it was hovering, and we took one picture of the airfield facing north, and then one picture facing south. So we were able to test the distortion between it being in the center of the picture and on the side, and we found there was quite a bit more distortion with using the GoPro. And on the left side, you have the infrared, and this was done by the aerial alchemy people. And we found there was a lot less distortion between those two. And then above it, you have the two different maps that we made using Pix4ID. The one on the left is stitching the infrared photos together. And then the one on the right is a ortho map that is made using those pictures that we stitched together. Oh, sorry. So this one is the infrared. So these are the pictures that were taken. So it was pictures like these, and it was stitched together in a program to form a large picture. And then we had that large picture in a Pix4ID, and we were able to make the ortho map like that.
Let's just zoom it in. Can you see the picture?
Yeah, you can do that if you want. I just wanted to, because that IR multispectral. Make sure that's labeled correctly.
So yeah, this is actually the multispectral map. This is just the, I believe it was the red band.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then this is the ortho map with all the colors actually brought into their full color to show soil quality.
Okay.
Of course, this red area, that's gonna be the concrete, so that's why it's the brightest.
Okay, so we obviously tested multiple sensors. Each one has their, each one has their advantages and disadvantages. Some we found that are very, very specialized for this particular application, may not have been necessary. It could be useful, but not really necessary. So the LIDAR We did have a functioning LiDAR sensor. We did have functioning LiDAR software for afterwards. We weren't able to process those images. So those are the ones we don't have results for. Infrared, we were thinking, if this was a more natural lake, it's either man-made or it was partially man-made in rainforest. There may be some more marshland area around the edge of the lake. So our concern there is if we're gonna have, this is an event space, we're gonna have vehicles coming through, we're gonna have tents set up. Is it all solid ground? Is it marshland? Things that you may not be able to tell from a distance. So if we can check if there's a difference in temperature from the water to the land, we may be able to tell if the land is stable enough for a road, storage space, staging area. So the infrared was able to tell that. However, given the nature of the lake, they have pretty solid banks and very defined cleared dirt areas. We didn't really feel like it was necessary. For the RGB on the Phantom, really high quality images from a distance, and the color comes out. I think having a color image by itself instead of a black and white definitely is advantageous to us. And again, given the nature of the lake that is very solid on the shores, we thought this would be the best sensor to go with. Just a high quality color image was very useful for us. The GoPro, everyone's familiar with the fisheye nature of a GoPro lens. Advantage to that is from a shorter distance, less flying time, you're able to get better situational awareness of the entire area. However, if you're trying to map out that area for an event space of how much room you can have, how big of a tent you can put, it's a little bit harder to get some distance measurements with the fisheye lens. Multispectral, again, we're kind of going on the same thought process as the infrared, given that the multispectral was often used to test the health of vegetation. If we can do that around the bank, again, see the differences between where the water would be and where the land actually is, we can tell with the multicolored image on the bottom right. So it might be a little hard to tell, but the light green is gonna be the real healthy vegetation. The dark red or dark orange is going to be no vegetation, which is obviously the runway cutting across from the bottom right to upper left. So very useful technology. However, for our application, we didn't really feel like that was the best way to go. So we're gonna stick with the RGB was the best sensor for our use.
Yeah, going off of that, we definitely thought LiDAR because we know it's capable of doing much more. We thought that would be the better choice at first, but with that being said, it was just too much more than we needed, and we ended up going with the RGB because it was just perfect. And then the LiDAR also didn't process the data correctly. We couldn't figure that part after. It was just not cooperating with us. But some of the complications we had was we weren't really thinking about like battery usage at first because we flew the drone out from where we start, like what was that, the Condor? We right from there all the way to the river, and it was just like battery drained so quickly, and we realized like we should just like walk all the way out there. So we walked very close and then flew the drone out there, and we were able to get more pictures, and the battery life was saved by that. And also, if we contacted a lot of companies, but it was really difficult to have them wanting to reach out to us to let us like demo sensors, or you know, because they knew we were students or for like educational purposes, they were not having that. A lot of them didn't even get back to us, but the ones that did, they left us hanging basically. And I feel like next time we probably would have Dr. Anderson like kind of lead them on maybe, and like we would probably get a demo out of that. I don't know. I feel like we would have.
They'd give us $1 million, it'd be great.
Yeah. So out of the five we tested, we were like, wow, it would have been much useful if we had like 10 sensors. So we were limited in that way. But of course, we still got what we needed, but it would have been nice to have more access to sensors. So we had to work with what we had. We also had some difficulties with like the Mika sensor because of the limited range for the Wi-Fi and stuff. It wasn't connecting, so we were having trouble with that. And just as you said, like the fish eyes came out distorted and it wasn't for what we wanted to, so we're like, this is not gonna work out for distance wise. So yeah, the RGB was the best sensor for measuring distances. And we have to say the Phantom Pro 4 had the best imagery.